Over the next couple of videos, we're going to look at a real-world example of using classes in our C# applications. In this program, we're going to create a class called Invoice that a hardware store might use to represent an invoice for an item sold at the store. Our invoice is going to include four pieces of information. We're going to need a part number, a part description, a quantity, and the price of the item. Once you have lined out the properties or the items that need to be held in your class, you'll need to define which data types are going to best fit. So in this case, a part number could be a string. A part description could also be a string. The quantity could be an integer, and the price will be a decimal. Once you have the members of your class lined out, then you can start coding the class. You may also want to think about methods. What are some of the functions that your class will need to perform on the data? In this case, we're going to create a method called getInvoiceAmount. GetInvoiceAmount is going to calculate the amount of the invoice, so we'll multiply the quantity by the price to get a total. Since quantity and price are both located in our class members, we know that getInvoiceAmount is not going to need to take in any items in its parameter list in order to perform this action. We are, however, going to need to return the total value, so it will need to return a decimal. So next, let's get into Visual Studio and start coding our invoice class. Here we are in Visual Studio, and I've created a new project named Hardware Store Example. So to get started coding our invoice class, we'll come to our Solution Explorer and right-click on the project and add a class. We're then going to name it Invoice. Visual Studio will create our new class named Invoice, and you can see it over here in our Solution Explorer as invoice.cs. When thinking about your plan for your class and which properties that you're going to have inside of it, you can also determine which properties are okay to auto-implement and which ones you're going to want access to in order to validate or do any error checking inside of the set. So in this case, I don't believe that we need to do anything with part number or part description, so I will be auto-implementing those two properties. However, quantity and price will need some validation since they're numerical values, and we want to ensure that we're not going to get any negatives or values that ultimately are not appropriate for quantity and price. So these two will be fully implemented with private variables so that we can have access to the set accessor for doing that error checking. In the next video, we will get started setting up our private variables and our public properties for this class. We will also set up the constructor, which will take all four pieces of information that we have outlined and initialize a new invoice object.